Jeffrey Howard here, aka Middleman Mentor, depending on what platform you see this, back with another credit building video. And today I want to talk about credit utilization. All right, so right here, the two cards that I have on my website as recommended cards to build credit, they're right here. We got the Discover, then we got the Capital One, right? So with these two cards right here, right, you have a due date and you have a report date. Let me turn the light on real quick, guys. You got a due date and you got a report date. So the due date is when the actual card payment is due. The report date is when it reports to the credit bureaus to show exactly where you at with the utilization. So the due date, you always want to at least pay the minimum so you don't get any late fees, okay? But the thing about this is you can do credit utilization if you know how to rock your cards out right. How we doing that? So with the Capital One, you can call and set when you want your due date. So call, set your due date up for like the 12th. It's going to report on the 15th, all right? Call and set the Discover up for the 22nd. It's going to report on the 25th. So we got a week to 10 days to utilize the funding from this card right here, hiding it, and then when this card due, we pay it back off. Understand what I'm saying? So you got 300 on this. I don't recommend you doing this while we're building. But after they become unsecured cards and they give you that $500,000 limit, okay, like I say, I don't recommend like using these small limit cards this way. But as you go up on your limits, this is just a demonstration on us getting started. We don't got in a little hole. We need some extra money real quick to run a play, to build up some more money. Don't go blowing your money on no stupid stuff. I ain't here to educate you on that, right? But we need some money, right? So we take the card off the Capital One card. How we get the card off, Jay? You got gift cards to money order. You can go buy some crypto bitcoins. You can do the refund play when you buy something and go refund it and then put it back on your debit card instead of the actual credit card. There's different ways to get the card. I do a video on that too. Different ways to get the money off the credit card with small fees or sometimes no fees at all. So don't worry about that. We got Plastique. You know what I mean? But anyway, back on this play. So you get the card, you get the money off the card. Okay, we've got 10 days to run the play, but we still got the money on this card. So now, as soon as the play about to be ready, we gonna pay this card back off. As soon as that card paid off and the report day hit, and we know this card coming back around. Now we take the money off this card and get ready to pay this card back off. So now we pay this card back off, the report day hit on the 15th. Okay, boom. So after hit on the 15th, and we know reports because we're keeping up with the credit monitoring service. If you don't have a credit monitoring service, that's basically like a bank account. Y'all paying a little $5, $10 when you don't have enough money in your bank account, but you don't have a credit monitoring service, so you can keep an eye on the play, keep your eye on the ball. If you need a credit monitoring service, go to the description and go to GT Approve and get set up in my DIY credit repair course. I got a credit monitoring service right there that's going to keep your eye on the ball. So you want to know when these plays hit. Okay, boom, it hit. Sometimes it hit on the 15th. Sometimes it hit on the 17th. But whenever it hit, you take the money back off that card and then you put it back on the other card. So all you're doing is washing the cards back and forth until that play, whatever you did to take that money off, which I don't recommend with low limit cards. All right, I don't recommend a low limit card, but whatever it is, when you pay it back off and balance out everything, it never show and affected your credit score. Because when you get the maxing out cards and they're reporting that, it stays on your report as so. You know what I mean? Like if it reports and it show that you max it out, that'll hinder you from getting your increases. Every 6 months, you should be getting the increase. Either they naturally going to do it or you calling and you running the play. You got to stay on top of it so you don't drop the ball. All right, so that's Middleman Mentor on utilizing the credit card play, switching the due date and the report date on both cards at least 10 days apart, one earlier in the month and one later in the month, so you have a little money to play with throughout the month to run the play to get you some more cash. You know what I mean? I'm getting good at this, man. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm living it. And everything I'm telling y'all is it's a demonstration of what I already been through. So I'm already going through these plays like that. And I feel like you should do the same. Not feel like you should do the same. You should definitely do the same. Make sure you subscribe to this YouTube channel because we got more information coming. Really game-changing information, especially coming into 2022. We're keeping our foot on your neck. We're going to make sure we bless the ones and help the ones that's out here trying to figure it out and trying to get it. Just need a little bit of mentorship. That's what Middleman Mentor is here for. You feel me? Until the next one, we out. Peace.